Happy Meditation Monday. This is Michelle Chua, and today is our last of our 7-week series in which we'll practice mindfulness meditation. And because this style of meditating is so much about being with what is, not very much specific technique to it, I would like you to start by opening your body and being fully present in it. So find an upright seat, perhaps elevated on a pillow, firm cushion, and take a moment to rock side to side. Feel both of your sitting bones plug in towards the earth, like I am here now. And as you bring your hands to your rib cage, actually lift all four walls of your ribs, the back, the front, the left and right, and feel that lengthening in your lower spine and that slight toning in of the belly. So as you maintain that, feeling the space in the lower middle spine, lift your chest and broaden it. Let your shoulders soften behind you as you slide the shoulder blades down. And then with your hands just softly resting on your lap, sit up tall through the crown of your head, as if your spine was an antenna from the heaven to the earth. And let's start by closing your eyes, simply observing what thoughts come to your mind. And if you start to notice you're straying away into a long story within the thoughts, reground yourself by feeling your body breathing naturally. So paying attention to whatever arises, positive thoughts, even some maybe not so comfortable. Continue to breathe naturally, and we'll use your breath as the object of meditation, in which it brings you back to here and now, when you start to feel your mind fall into the abyss of one story after another. Simply observing when a new thought comes, as though you're flipping pages of a magazine. Also noticing if any self-judgment comes, especially when you attempt to redirect back to your breath and reground. Letting go of any sort of criticism to yourself, allow it to be like a gentle hand in which you reach out to your mind to softly guide it back to here and now. Feeling your body breathing once again. Feeling your sitting bones on your cushion of the earth, your spine upright. Very slowly, very softly begin to flutter your eyes open. So part of the point of mindfulness meditation is to really sit with what is and allow what lies in our subconscious mind to come to the surface and enable us to see patterns. Maybe patterns of repetition where we continue swaying our attention towards, and perhaps sometimes negative or an experience that we haven't fully digested, and it comes up to the surface for us to recognize. And it's a beautiful thing, even when it doesn't feel so beautiful or so happy and pleasurable, but to be able to see these parts of ourselves and address them in a conscious level. For example, noticing triggers. I've meditated for times, reliving an experience, and realizing how my reaction to maybe what somebody said was really connected to something in my past, like in childhood. And when these feelings come out and I feel them physically as sensations in my body, often here at the chest where the heart lies, I realize that they haven't been fully digested, that I carry them on me, and when something else happens in the future, in the present now, they're like buttons that can time warp me back into the past and relive as if this new context was exactly the same old context. So these kinds of things, these insights about ourselves, can come up through sitting and simply observing our mind in a kind, loving way, not in a berating, judgmental way. And I highly recommend, first thing in the morning, to sit, have that allotted time as we spoke about a few sessions ago, and allow yourself to be in it, to be in even the discomfort. Like, as some have said, the only way out of a negative situation is through it. And sometimes it is negative feeling at the time, but really if you put it in the larger perspective of that, everything that happens to us on this planet in this lifetime is a lesson for our own evolution and for us to help each other to rise in that greater consciousness of oneness. Thank you for joining me on these Meditation Mondays. I'd love to hear your feedback. Namaste.